Welcome to evening prayer with the Stamford Methodist Circuit for Sunday, the 4th of June, as we pray together on this evening of Trinity Sunday. June is being observed as Bible Month by the Methodist Church, and the Stamford Methodist Circuit is participating in this, with the focus on the final book in the Bible, the Revelation of St. John. Towards the end of our prayers each day, we'll touch on the recommended passage from Revelation, sharing a thought and/or a question for further reflection. There won't be time to include the whole passage in our evening prayers, but you're encouraged to read and reflect on it in your own time, aware that others in our circuit and further afield will also be doing so. The guide for our evening prayers today and throughout the coming week is the theme suggested in the Methodist Church Prayer Handbook, which is Holy, 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 a very appropriate phrase, especially for today, Trinity Sunday, when our worship and reflections are focused on the mystery of God's being as three in one and one in three, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So let us pray. Blessed are you, Sovereign God, our light and our life. To you be glory and praise for ever. When we turned away to darkness and chaos, like a mother you would not forsake us. You cried out like a woman in labour and rejoiced to bring forth a new people. Your living word brings light out of darkness, and daily your spirit renews the face of the earth, bending our wills to the gentle rule of your love. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, blessed be God for ever. Amen. And we share together the hymn suggested for today in the Methodist Church Prayer Handbook, number 5 from the Singing the Faith hymn book, one of Charles Wesley's great hymns, sung in this recording to the tune Diadematta, the hymn Father, in whom we live. Anthologies that he's compiled, William Sykes includes a number of helpful quotes on the theme of holiness. I'll be drawing on these in our prayers this week, and this evening we turn to some words by a writer called Olive Wyon, an author and translator of Christian books. The quotation is from her work entitled On the Way. Olive writes, "What are the marks of holiness of life? First and foremost, and all the time, love. Love is the force which unites and holds together all those qualities and graces which combine to form a completeness or maturity in a human life. Another essential sign of holiness is dependence upon God. Holiness is not the search for an individual perfection, nor for the production of a beautiful character, which we hope people will admire. If the pursuit of holiness is begun with any thought of this kind, from the outset it is doomed to fail, for it shows that we are full of spiritual pride, and where this is so, the way to true holiness is blocked by our self-importance. Real spiritual life is very personal. It is true, but it is not individualistic or self-regarding. It is a life lived in close touch with other people, in the church and outside it, but at the same time, a life that is secretly lived in absolute dependence on God for everything, at every moment." And so we move from those words to hear this evening's recommended Bible reading, a version of the reading set for Trinity Sunday this year, the closing verses of St. Matthew's Gospel, often referred to as Jesus's Great Commission to his followers. Matthew chapter 28, verses 16 to 20.
After Jesus had come back to life, he appeared to his disciples on several different occasions, over a period of 40 days. The last time was when the 11 disciples were gathered together on a hill above Lake Galilee. Jesus appeared and encouraged them, telling the disciples that they had a special job to do. Jesus told them that he had to leave and return to heaven, but he promised to send them the power of a special helper, God's Holy Spirit. Jesus was passing his authority to them to be his messengers and to go out into the whole world and tell everyone all about him. Jesus said to his disciples, "Go then and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, till the very end of the age."
In fulfilling Jesus's great commission, we apply the holiness and love which Olive Wyand's words helped us to reflect on a few moments ago. And so let us pray. Three in one God, three things we ask of you, that we may see you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly day by day. May we see you more clearly in the world around us, in the needs of our neighbours, in the social and political events of history. May we love you more dearly in the delight of worship and devotion, in the challenge of service, in the enthusiasm with which we tell people about you. May we follow you more nearly into the places where people are struggling for justice, into the wilderness of people's grief and pain, into the situations where peace is absent. Three in one God, strengthen and sustain us as we seek to be your people day by day. We pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Today's recommended Bible Month passage is Revelation 3, verses 1 to 22, a continuation of the angelic messenger letters to some of the early Christian churches. In these verses, the church at Sardis is called to wake up and learn from the example of a few key Christians. The church at Philadelphia does well, but the church at Laodicea needs to repent and open the door to Jesus once more, for they have gone lukewarm. The question for reflection posed in response to this reading is, if you are part of a church, is its door fully open to Jesus? We share a piece of music which picks up some of the words from the prayers we shared a few moments ago, and which itself is a prayer for deeper faith.
Day by day, day by day.
Rest in the love of God the Father. Rest in the love of Jesus God the Son. Rest in the love of God the Holy Spirit. The love of the sacred three, your rest place be. Amen. So thank you for sharing in this time of prayer. God bless you.